Okay, so let's continue on with this example. And so we've got what we've got in place so far is, if I can get it ready here. Okay, so what we've got in place so far is we've asked the user to enter a sentence. We've looked, or we started our do loop, and then we're checking to see if the user wants to enter another sentence or queue to quit. And that's what we've done so far. So what's next inside the loop? So we're going to get the first character. Now how do we do that? How do we get at the first character, which is currently sitting out in user sentence, which is a string, right? So the user's typed something in, and we want to get at that first character. Well, what I would suggest doing is putting it into that temporary char that we created. So let's set that char equal to the first character. How do we get at the first character? Well, this is where we get to use some of these methods that we've talked about. To be able to get the character at a specific location, luckily for us, there's a method built into the string itself to be able to get that character. So we get to go into the user sentence, and get the char at what position? Now remember that the first position in a string is actually the zero position. We start at zero. Okay? So ch user sentence char at zero, and that should give us the first character. Let's test it out. I'll just put a little print statement in here to make sure this is even working right. We'll print ch, okay? So if I now go in and say blah, then it prints the B because that is the first character, the char at position zero in that sentence, blah, which is not really a sentence. Okay? Okay, so we've got that char isolated. Now, what do we want to do? Well, let's check to make sure the first character is a capital letter. Okay, so we're going to say if the char that we found is a capital. Well, how do we check that? Huh. I know that in the string method there's an is uppercase or two uppercase to make the whole thing uppercase, or the two lowercase to make the whole thing lowercase. How do I check? Well, I can't use the string for this. I'm going to need one of our other methods that we've talked about. And again, as I pull these up here, let's look at this. So the character Java class, there it is. So the character class allows us to look at chars and do specific things with them. So one of the things that we can do with a char is say, is this uppercase? Okay, so is it uppercase? So I can say if, now how do I access that class? Again, if I just say is uppercase and pass it the char, I'm going to get an error message that says cannot find the symbol is uppercase. And I'm saying, well, wait a second, it's right there. But it's not part of this class, right? There's nothing in here. There's no method called is uppercase. It's part of the character class. So I need to go type in the name of that class, character class, dot is uppercase. Now Java has no problem with it because it knows where that uppercase method is coming from. Okay, so if it is uppercase, is that what we're actually looking for though? Well, no, we're actually looking to see if it's lowercase, I guess is probably the better way of putting that, or if it's not uppercase. So we could put a not out in front of this. We could say if it's not uppercase, or we can say is lowercase. If it is lowercase, then what do we want to do? Well, I want to make it uppercase, but how do I know that? Because I don't even know what character it's going to be. Well, again, in the character method, we have a to uppercase method where we pass in a char and it will make it uppercase. It'll return a char that's uppercase, right? Returns the uppercase equivalent of the character, if any, otherwise the character itself. So if the character that we found at position 0, that's the character that's in the CH variable right now. Okay, so if that character is lowercase, then we're going to say set that character equal to the character class dot to uppercase, and then we pass it the CH variable. Okay, so what we're doing here is taking and replacing whatever was in there with the uppercase equivalent of what was in there. So if we got a lowercase b, we would now have an uppercase b. We're overriding our own variable. We're overriding the CH variable with the uppercase equivalent, and now we can add that to the corrected string, right? Okay. All right. So now we've got that capitalized letter. Now, what do we do with it? Now, this is something we hadn't even talked about. And the problem is, we want to build a new sentence. Well, that's easy enough. We can just say, go into the corrected sentence. Well, I guess what we ought to do is this. Because we're at kind of a crossroads here. We got a problem. We want to build the new sentence. And if we just add the character to the sentence, in other words, if it already is an uppercase, then it's fine and we don't need to do anything. But if it isn't, then we need to replace this first character in the string with the updated uppercase character. Now, I'm thinking on the fly here, so I may not come up with the best way of doing this. But what I'm thinking is, if this is the case, then we want to set that string that we've created, the corrected sentence string, so corrected sentence, which is currently blank, and I want to set it equal to that char to begin with. Now, I don't know if it'll yell at me for this. Yeah, incompatible type. So I'll need to do the char plus a blank or something to make it so it accepts it fine. Yeah. So now it's saying whatever the char was plus a blank. This, in essence, makes it a string. Although we have a toString method, I guess I should probably use that, right? That's a better thing to do since we're doing this example. We have a toString method which returns the string of the char. So I'll just do that instead. Be a better example. So I'll set the corrected sentence equal to the char or the character class dot to string. And what is it that I'm making a string? Well, whatever's in the CH. Okay, and now the string will only be that one character, but this will work now. Well, what about the rest of the sentence? I have to get the rest of the sentence in there, right? Okay. Well, so let's go to that part next. So, well, the other part of this, what if it was lowercase or was uppercase? So the else part on this is if it's lowercase, do this, else what are we going to do? Well, we want that corrected sentence. I'm kind of working through this in my brain right now, trying to figure this out. And by the way, that's what a lot of programming is just problem solving, thinking about how we're going to do this. I need to come back to the drawing board here because I'm realizing that I don't want to actually, I can set that string. Let's just leave it like that for now. And then let's do the second check. So we're going to look to make sure the last character is a punctuation character. So we'll do kind of the same process to go get that last character. So I'll go set ch equal to the last character. The only problem is, how do I know what the last character is? So I'll go get the user sentence variable, and I want to get the char at position last. Well, how do I do that? Again, we have a nice little method in there that will give us the length of the user sentence. Okay, so I can say go into the user sentence and give me the length of that sentence, and that's the character that I want to look at, is whatever the last character is. The only problem is I'm going to get an error at runtime saying I'm out of bounds, because the length, when I just typed in blah, the length is 4, but the characters, because they start being numbered at 0, are 0, 1, 2, and 3. So when I just tried to access character 4, I got an illegal out of bounds exception. And so I don't actually want the length. I want the length minus 1 to account for that starting at 0 instead of starting at 1 with my counting. And now that should work. So blah, the program runs fine. And now I've got that last character isolated. So now I can do my checks on to see whether it's punctuation or not. Okay. So if the character that I found is not equal to what? Well, the first one is that's legal is a period. Okay. And it's not the character, again, I have to write the character again. I can't just say and not equal to question mark. If I do this, Java's going to yell at me and say there's an illegal start of expression there because I didn't put anything to compare. I have to do it again. I have to say ch is not equal to a question mark, and now it'll run fine. And ch is not equal to exclamation point. So if it's not one of those things, then we want to set the corrected sentence, the last character of it, equal to a period. Or not that we don't want to set the last character of it, we want to add a period. We don't want to overwrite what's already there. So I need to add to the corrected sentence. So I need to take corrected sentence, whatever it was, and set it equal to whatever it was plus a period. Does that make sense? So we're going to concatenate on a period to the end of the sentence if there was nothing else. Okay? And I had to do it this way because I had to say take what's ever in corrected sentence and add a period onto it and then put that back in the corrected sentence. Or sorry, not, we don't want to do corrected sentence, right? Well, this comes back to our other question, which is how do we want to handle this idea of we've got the first character, now what do we do with all the middle characters? Okay, and I think we'll kind of finish that out and take a look at that in the next video, that concept. Hopefully everybody's still hanging with me on this. All right, we'll finish it up in part 3. Spencer out.